โอเคสวัสดีครับ Have you been well my dear student Have you been well Yes you have Yes you have มา Let's come with me again right So this week we're gonna study about the learning process perspective okay That's our chapter 8in our textbook and from last week you remember from last week we also study about the psychosocial theory psychosocial theory is nothing but just the attachment that you attach to some self object such as your parents your mother your papa or something or someone that you just cling on right and that particular person will have you know the effect to your personalities all right and we have some kind of attachment that you study from last week remember we do have some kind of insecure secure avoid attachment and ambivalence attachment meaning it's just on and off sometimes you like sometimes you don't like so this is called the ambivalence attachment and we also study some ego identity so that is the you know when you grow up you try to learn you try to you tend to experience more about yourself and you tend to learn about your ego your ego will your conscience will learn more and more about what to behave what to do for example when you were born as a baby right you develop some sort of a trust and mistrust and when you are adolescents when you are teenagers you are like what you like to get some trend you need to be you need to get some identity right you need to be someone you try to have a role model you know or inferiority meaning you don't like to be anyone at all okay so what about the last one like the old age when you are senior right if your life is fulfillness if you success in everything so you're gonna have ego integrity right but if you in the opposite side if you have a very bad life your life is sucked then when you are old you're gonna get despair I mean you're gonna be regret you know as long as you live so you want to die right now you don't want to live anymore so that is what we have learned in the past you know in the previous chapter right but this chapter is the learning process the learning perspective so what are we going to study about this chapter well very simple so for the thing that I want to give out to you is about this chapter is only a few you know subtopics only a few points that I just want to give it to you guys okay it's very simple straightforward okay just take you about 20 or 30 minutes okay not that long I promise you that okay so be with me don't go anywhere now for this chapter as I told you this is about the learning process okay for the learning process this is the thing that we have been doing you know since we were born you and me everyone we have to learn when you open your eyes you learn already so the learning process is the thing that we do every single day for the rest of our life okay like remember from last week I mean right we when we grow up we tend to learn something consciously about our ego identity so this is what we always do we are the learning machine so we learn all the time so what we learn become our behavior become our personalities okay so speaking of learning there are two kinds of learning okay to like the process of learning there are like two process and it has to do with the conditional okay so we have some condition so what is the condition is something that you know we have to take care of in order something to happen so the condition so the process of learning are separated into two condition now you take note okay you take note the process of learning has two condition the first one is classical condition again the process of learning has two condition the first one is classical okay I just write here classical condition the second one is instrumental. So this topic, okay, this chapter just only talk about two conditions, the classical condition and the instrumental condition. So you must differentiate, you must know what is or what are the differences between the two conditions. The first one is classical, the second one is instrumental. Okay, instrumental is the second one and the first one is classical. So let me explain it to you. Let me elaborate more about the classical and instrumental, okay, and then we're gonna summarize to you in the near future. Okay, ma. So in order to learn about classical instrumental, we need to know about condition. Okay, so let me just take you to this photo. Okay, this photo. Okay. This is the process of classical condition. First, before conditioning, when the dog see the food, what happened to the dog? The dog get saliva. Okay, so the salivation is just the unconditional response because the food is just unconditional, you know, stimulus. What is the stimulus? Stimulus means something that arouses you to do some action. So stimulus can be food, the stimulus can be color, the stimulus can be the music. Even some music can move you to do something, right? For example, when you hear a rap music, you tend to be so when you hear rap music, right? So when you hear a sad music, you tend to cry. So that is called stimulation, all right? So that is a basic thing. So when you got a unconditional stimulus such as food, then the dog got saliva. So this is the basic thing. Next, you take a look at this photo, okay? This photo is before conditioning. Before conditioning, meaning when you ring the bell, we try to let the dog learn about the bell process. Now, you ring the bell, king, 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 king. The dog doesn't know anything, so the dog unrespond. The dog just doesn't have no response, no saliva, no nothing. Because the dog doesn't know that what the king king, what? I don't care about king king, king king. The more you king king, the more unrespond. So the dog has no response to the king king sound. Okay. So next, now you try to do conditioning. Conditioning meaning. You try to let the dog learn about the king king. The king king mean food. King king mean food, meaning you put them together. You put the bell ringing together with the food. So then the dog will have some, you know, some salivation, or the dog will get angry, will get hungry. All right, the dog will get some food. So the dog learning that now with this during the conditioning, the dog learned that hey, when there's a king king and the food, I'm going to get it. I'm going to get some food. I'm going to be hungry. I'm going to get some, you know, some meat, some chicken or whatever. So the dog learning. Okay. So saliva come with the unconditional response because the dog see this. This is unconditional. But next, the last process. This is the last process. See, this is after conditioning. After conditioning meaning, when the next time, when the dog hear the bell, king king, king king, king king, then the dog gets saliva already because he knows that king king sound meaning food, he get angry, he get hungry. So when he get hungry, he got some salivation. So this is conditional, right? Because you try to condition it with the bell, and then it got conditional response, all right? So conditional, you know, food, I mean, sorry, conditional bell, get the conditional saliva. But the conditional, you know, stimulus cannot create conditional response with the help of unconditional food, okay? Unconditional stimulus is the food. So it need to be learning, right? The dog need to learn about it first, okay? It need to learn that, right? Bell with food, bell is conditional. Food is unconditional stimulus. So together, with this happen together, it will create, you know, conditional response. okay? So conditional response will happen only when you put in the process of learning, and that learning you have to put what? You have to put conditional stimulus with the unconditional stimulus. The conditional stimulus is the bell. Unconditional stimulus is the food. So that is the thing has to go, have to combine in order to create what? Create conditional response. So this is the behavior, and this classical stimulus, okay, or this classical conditioning, it's just the action, it's just the stimulus that create the action, stimulus that create the action, okay? So this called illicit action. Illicit means coming out after you doing something, we call illicit. Illicit means you obtain the behavior by giving some stimulus, okay? So this is the thing, this is called classical conditioning. So the classical conditioning is a passive learning. Passive learning mean what? You need to do something first in order to create something. It's like a cause and effect. This happened first and then this will happen later, okay? No need to do anything with the punishment or reward because you just condition it, right? You just need to condition with something, or you just need to arouse them with some, atmosphere. For example, another example, look here. So when you see this picture, right? It's a very nice restaurant. Very nice restaurant with the aquarium, tank or anything. So when you take your girlfriend to have this dinner together in this atmosphere, it could be unconditional atmosphere, okay? Unconditional stimulus. What happened when you eat this? You might feel a bit, you might get aroused. You might need some, a bit of a sexual behavior, like you need to go bang bang something or boom bang, bing boom bang. So this is the thing, okay? So when you see this lamp with the Italian food, you might get sexually aroused. So, okay? So this sexually aroused could be your unconditional response. So when you see something like this, the next picture, see, nice restaurant, but different, like, different, view, because previously it was aquarium, but this time it's just the scenic view of the downtown view from high point, from high, building, high rises building, but this sort of environment, this sort of stimulus could create another sexual arousal. Okay, because it's very similar, right? Very similar. So this term, we can call it generalization, okay? This one. So this thing bring me to this, topic. So for the classical condition, we have a term called generalization. Generalization meaning when you see something similar or when you feel something similar, you will produce the same, behavior. Okay, for example, like I told you, right? Like this one, nice atmosphere, nice restaurant, you can create, some sexual behavior or something, right? Then this is called generalization. So next time when you go to even this kind of restaurant, a bit brighter, more bright, still you can feel some sexual arousal. So this is very basic thing, okay? So when you have dinner with your boyfriend or girlfriend, when you see this sort of thing, nice romantic dinner, then you tend to have some, sexual behavior after this meal. So this is called, it can create, conditional response. Okay, all right. So with the what do you call it? unconditional stimulus or conditional stimulus, it could both create, you know, conditional response, meaning having, you know, having to think of the sexual behavior afterwards. So this is the thing. So now, even when you see this kind, even when you see this kind of restaurant, you might feel, oh, I want to have some sex. I want to have sex lah. I want to have sex lah. So this, even with this atmosphere, meaning generalization. So whenever you eat food, whenever you have, you know, a dinner or a lunch or with your girlfriend, see, like anything, you're just thinking of what? Thinking of sexual behavior. You want to have sex. So this called generalization. Get it? Generalization. Okay, now this is the term that I want you to understand. Okay, generalization. Okay, I will zoom it. Generalization. Okay, next term that I want you to understand is discrimination. Discrimination meaning what? Meaning if you like the aquarium view, all right, and then when you have another restaurant that is not the same view, so you just discriminate. You don't feel sexually aroused anymore. So this is so-called discriminate. Discriminate means you try to differentiate. It has to be exactly red color, dim light, Italian food, then you get sexually aroused. So only with that condition. Okay, so if something different, for example, the view different what? From aquarium to the, you know, high-rise building, downtown scenery, then you don't get arousal, you know, sexual arousal anymore. Meaning you try to discrimination. Discrimination means you differentiate. It must be only this specific, you know, information. Then we'll create that response. Okay, so this called discrimination. But for the generalization, meaning no matter what view, no matter what restaurant, you still want to have sex. That is generalization. I hope you understand it. Okay. And the last term that I want you to remember is extinction. Extinction mean. Okay. Meaning like this. Meaning when you see the same stimulus. For example, when you take your girlfriend to sit at a very good restaurant with the aquatic view, you think of sexual arousement and then you do have some sex, right? But if you go to the same restaurant but you don't have sex anymore, you just keep on no sex, even though the stimulus are the same. Get it? Like stimulus are the same. For example, same table, same light, same atmosphere, the aquatic scene and everything, but still you no sex anymore, right? So that behavior, that response or the condition response will be eliminated from yourself, eliminate from your personality. So you tend to do the extinction. Mean even with the same stimulus, it won't produce the same response anymore. So you just tend to forget about everything. Okay, so if same thing happen, if you don't do it, if you just obstacle mean like you just try to not to do it. Okay, you try to just try to do something else instead of doing the same response that you do. So the previous response will be eliminated, or we call it extinction. All right, so that is the thing that I just want you to understand. Okay, there are three words, huh? Remember now, three words. The first one is what? The first one is generalization, meaning no matter what the stimulus, you will produce the same response. This is called generalization. Okay, the second one is what? Discrimination means it must only be that specific detail, specific stimulus, in order to create some response. That is called discrimination. So when you change something, this response will no longer happen. Okay, all right, so discriminate means you just need to be exactly the same time only. Then next, the extinction meaning what? Meaning even you know, the same stimulus, even though the same stimulus happened, but still you try to uphold, or you just want to stop the previous. You never do the previous response anymore. So the previous response that you need to, that you already had, will be eliminated. So for example, when you go to the Italian restaurant with the colleague, you tend to have sex, right? But you just stop having sex, even though you go to the same restaurant, meaning that sex behavior will be eliminated. So it will be extinction. Extinction means no more happen, even though they are the same, like, same stimulus. Okay? Now, I think you understand the thing that I just want to tell you, okay? And then for the conditional, okay, for the conditional, classical conditional, yeah, there's another effect that also, you know, related to the classical conditioning, okay? That is called emotional conditioning. So classical conditioning also, you know, have some effect to the emotional conditioning. So because some of the action or some of the stimulus will just affect your feeling, right? Because like you're feeling good when you see roses. So see, that's the thing. For example, when you see red color, you might fear of losing something. Because your teacher grade you with the red ink, right? You remember? And then whenever you see red ink, you just feel like bad memory about getting a very low grade. Because your teacher just cut your mark with the red ink. Red ink mean cut mark. So whenever you see red, you feel bad about it. So this is the thing of the, you know, classical conditioning. So it affects your emotion. So that's why we have emotional conditioning, and the emotional conditioning is also the subset of classical conditioning. Okay, and that is number one. Remember, we have two condition. The first one is classical condition. The second one is instrumental condition. Now, let's talk about instrumental condition. Yes. Instrumental condition. So this is the last topic now for this chapter. Instrumental condition is what? Instrumental condition, sometimes we call operant condition. So once again, operant, instrumental, they are the same name, but different, you know, different words, okay? But they are the same meaning. Again, operant, and instrumental, they are the same thing, okay? So this second perspective of learning, so-called instrumental learning, is what? This process of learning is an active learning, not like before. The previous one, conditional learning, is the passive, because you need to do some stimulation first, and then the action will come afterward, right? So this is the first classical conditional, conditioning. But the second one is instrumental. Instrumental means you need to do something first, and then if that thing is good or no good, then there will be some consequences. That consequences is going to be like reward and punishment. So this instrumental condition has to do with reward and punishment, and it is an active learning. For example, like, let's take me for example. When I was very young, when I go to the mall or when I go to Central, I just, you know, when I need something, I just crying out loud. When I cry, my mom come to me and then give me some money to buy some toys. Then I'm so happy. So see, I learned that when I cry, my mom give me money. So I cry. Money, cry mean money. So see, I cry first, I do the action first, and then the reward will come. So this is the thing. But what happened if I cry, you know, to others? You know, not, that's not my mom. That's one example. Now, that's one situation, that when I go to the, you know, to the mall with my brother. So I just happened to do the same thing because I need a toy. So I just cry, but this time, this is without my mom, right? This is my brother. My brother just bang me, hit me, bang, bang, bang. Then suddenly I stop crying because he doesn't give me money, but instead he just kicked me. So, you know, this instrumental condition, you know, it give me the feedback, or give me what to do and what not to do, you know, with the reward and with the punishment. So this is the difference between, you know, the first one, which is a classical conditioning, and the second one, that is instrumental conditioning. So, you know, again, the active is the second one, instrumental. The passive is the first one, classical. So now let me just give you some idea, okay, of what is the difference between the two things, okay? Ma, okay? See, this is like, when you see this, and when you have, when you see this sort of, you know, restaurant, and still you want to have sex, meaning you are generalization, okay? Whatever that is, you just create the same response all the time. Okay, now, this is instrumental conditioning. So as I told you, right, instrumental meaning, the second one, now is the active behavior. So you need to do something first, and then, you know, the consequences will come. The consequences will be responded to the reward or punishment, reward or reinforcement and punishment. Okay, so this is the same thing. Instrumental sometimes is called operant. I already told you this. Okay, next. So this is the difference between classical and operant means instrumental. Okay, yeah. So this one, the classical invented by Pavlovian. Okay, this is in Russia. Okay, in Russia, Pavlovian. But for the operant or instrumental, developed in the US. Okay, in the US. Okay, and you can see that the behavior is from illicit. Illicit mean it can be obtained afterward. Okay, obtained afterward, meaning you need to do some stimulation first, and then the behavior will come after the stimulation. But for this, behavior is emitted. Emitted means you do something, like you just act something and then wait for the response. Wait that, hey, you get spanked or you get reward. So if you get reward, meaning you can do that, you know, behavior in order to get some reward. All right, so this is the difference between the two. Okay, the two. And then one more. Okay, so for the punishment and for the reward, okay, for the punishment and for the reward, again, my dear student, for the instrumental or the operant, it has to do with punishment and reward. Punishment and reward, okay? Punishment and reward. So now, come with me. So for the punishment and reward, it go like this. Present mean reward. Unpresent mean punishment, okay? So for the present and for the, you know, unpresent, reward and punishment, we need to do something. This is positive reward. Positive reward means you add something. Negative reward, remove means you try to do the negative reward. Okay, again, this thing is positive reward. Okay, positive reward. This thing is negative reward. Negative reward means you try to move away something. Okay, move away something. This is punishment. So this is positive punishment when you add something. Now, it's called positive punishment. And it's called negative punishment. Negative punishment meaning you try to reduce something. Okay, now let me explain it to you. What are this, you know, punishment and reward means to our instrumental? Now look at this. This is the star. This is the star. Okay, so let's say like this. If you have a baby or if you have a child, when your child do something good, for example, if you have two child, okay, if you have two sons, the first son is the older son and the younger son. If you have two sons, when they're not fighting, when they're happy, when they study good things, when they have a good grade, you just give them the star. Just give them the star. Okay, so when they're not fighting, even though they are arguing with something, but they're not fighting, they behave very good, right? They behave well. So you just give them star, star, star. This is called positive, positive, and then positive reward or positive reinforcement. Okay, again, so with the positive, you know, reward, meaning you give something in order for your sons to do something good. All right, give something. When he do something good, you give something to him. When you do something good, you give something to him. When he do something good, you give something to him. So this is called positive reinforcement or the positive reward. Then next term, this one, the negative reward. Negative reward mean like this. Negative reward mean like this. You have to look at this picture and then think, you know, follow me. Nah, just pondering and then listen to me and then think along with what I'm trying to tell you. For the negative reward, when your son are fighting, when your son fighting, so he's doing something very bad, right? Fighting, hey, I don't like you, I hate you. So when your two son fighting, instead of giving them the star, right? Because they are not doing a good thing. So you know that your son love toys. You know that your son love toy. So they love toy, they pleasure toys, they love toys. So you're just doing the negative reward, meaning negative mean you take away, you remove. So you just remove their toy. When you fight, you fire, you two fighting, you fighting with your brother. When you fight, I take your toy. When you fight, I take your toy. When you fight, I take your toy. So the boy will learn that, hey, if I fight, then papa will take away toy, right? So I won't fight anymore. I won't fight because I don't want my toy to be removed. So this is called negative reward. Negative reward means you try to take away what they like in order for them not to do something, okay? So when you take away, then they will tend to reduce their behavior, reduce their bad behavior. Bad behavior means fighting. You just try to reduce the fighting by take away their toy, okay? Get it? Yes, all right, I hope you get it. Just try to ponder and think. Nah? So this is called negative reinforcement, or we just call it negative reward. Now, next, come back to this. The third one is called positive punishment. Positive punishment, meaning what? When your boy's fighting, hey, banging, you just hit them. The more you fight, the more you hit. If they fight harder, you just hit harder. Bang. Because what? Because they are fighting. So you try to, you know, push more, hit more, do more, add more, add spiking, right? When you try to, you know, reduce their bad behavior. So this is called positive punishment. So when your boy did something wrong, you just spank them, you just hit them, you just, you know, curse them or whatever. So this is called positive punishment. All right, hit. So when you try to lower their bad behavior by adding the thing that they don't like. So you get it, right? So when they did something wrong, when they did something wrong, such as fighting, you know, against each other, you just hit them, hit them, hit them, hit them, hit them, like that. So this is called positive punishment. And the last term, we call negative, okay? Negative punishment. So what is the negative punishment? Look at this picture. This is the veggie. No, children love veggie. They just hate veggie. So when your son not fighting, then you just say, oh, not fighting, huh? If you're not fighting, okay. When not fighting, you just take away the veggie. Okay, then you just tell them, today you don't need to eat veggie now. You can eat just rice and pork and egg. Veggie, we don't need to eat veggie because you just take away what they don't like. So that they will do more, you know, the way that you ask them to do. So they will be like more peaceful, no fighting with their brother, So when they are no fighting with their brother, you just tell them no eat veggie lah, no eat veggie. You just eat rice, you just eat pork, you just eat, I know, tumongki. You just eat the chicken, bon chicken, bon chon. You eat chicken, no veggie lay. Because if you're a bad boy, I take veggie away. You not bad boy, I take veggie away. So this is called the negative punishment. So that your son will try to do more of a good behavior. Okay. So these are the, you know, the four basic thing about the punishment and reward. So they are four basic, right? Remember, reward means positive reward, and then negative reward. Also for the punishment, they are positive punishment and negative punishment. And I just explained to you all about the thing, right? Remember, yeah, this the star. When your son do something good, you give them more star. It's called positive reward. Okay. So when your son do something bad, you just take away their toy so that they will do something good. All right. So for this, when your son did something bad, you just spank them to stop their behavior, stop their bad behavior by adding more and more punishment. Okay. Like spank them so they hate. If they hate being spanked, they will stop bad behavior, remember? And the last thing, okay? So if they are good boy, you just take away what they don't like. For example, you know, just tell them, you don't need to eat veggie because you are a good boy, okay? So if you are a good boy, no eat, but if you are a bad boy, you have to eat more veggie now. So this is another thing, okay? So this is, you know, is a real super punishment. So this is different. You need to consider it nicely. Again, positive means you add something. Negative means you try to take away something. Okay. So these are the things that you should know. So for this chapter, once again, learning perspective. There are two perspectives, okay? Now conclusion now. The first one is classical conditioning. The second one is instrumental conditioning. And the classical, okay, it need the stimulus. For the instrumental, no need to get the stimulus. You do the action first, and then we control the action by using punishment and reward. So punishment and reward is used in the instrumental, stimulus used in the classical condition. So I think you enjoy this. Okay, bye bye, see you, love you, สวัสดีครับ.